Hello and welcome back to my channel guys, this is Anand and you're watching Physics Craze. If you haven't subscribed my channel yet, then do subscribe it to get the quality content regularly, and don't forget to press the bell icon so that you'll get notified every time I upload a new video. So in this video, we're gonna find the electric field due to some charge distribution, and this is the first case that we're gonna solve in this whole video, and we're gonna solve a question from there also. So without wasting too much time, let's get started. So we're gonna do the whole derivation because these are some special cases that you should know, you should remember the results of these cases so that you can directly apply to the questions. And there are a lot of questions in different entrance exams have been asked depending on these special cases. The first case is we have some symmetric arc on XY plane. Here you can see this is my arc and it has some charge distribution, uniform charge distribution, having uniform charge distribution lambda. And so we can write lambda as dq over dl. Directly we can write that dq over dl. Now we cannot write dl as dx, dy or dz because it is not lying in any of the axes, not x, not y, not z. And we have radius of that arc is r. See, the radius is r, and here we have the angle that the arc make, here it is alpha. So what we have to find, we have to find the net electric field at the center. So let us move ahead with a step by step procedure. Now let's consider a small part of this whole arc. So we can say the length of this part is dl and the charge it contains is dq, we can say that. And let us consider the angle that it makes with the center or with the y axis would be theta. Let us consider I'm measuring theta from here. It is not mandatory that you should always measure theta from x axis because I'm not using here any kind of coordinate system. That's why I can take theta anywhere. So we can say that this small length would create a small d theta angle. So from the arc length multiplication, arc length calculation, we can say this small length dl would be r d theta. We can write that this small length dl would be r d theta. Now let us see the electric field due to this small charge. So the electric field due to this small charge would be in this direction. Let's consider this is dE. If this angle is theta, so this angle would also be theta, and we know that to find E net we have to form the component of dE. It means to find the component of dE, as we can write dE as k dq divided by capital R square because this is the radius. But to find E net we cannot directly integrate dE, we cannot do this, we have to find the components of dE. So for that we're gonna write the component of dE as, let us consider dEx, means in x direction we can write dE as k dq R square multiply by sine theta. And we are just talking about magnitude, not direction. That's why I'm not putting here negative sign. Okay. And what about dE in y direction? We can write k dq over r square cos theta. And from this, we can write dq as lambda into dl. And from here, we have write dl equals to rd theta. So we can write dq as lambda rd theta. Now we have to find the net electric field, so we can write Ex in x direction, in y direction separately, because we can write E net as we know from my first video, I can write Ex I cap plus Ey j cap, because the arc is in plane xy plane, we don't know the resultant direction of electric field. So we can write, and we have to solve separately for different axes. So for Ex we can write Ex as integration of dEx, and for Ey we can write integration of dEy. So here dEx we have k dq over r square sine theta, and dEy we have k dq r square cos theta. But dq we have lambda r d theta. So let me put all the values here. We can write ex as integration of k, and in terms of dq we can write lambda r d theta divided by r square into sine theta. Similarly for y we can write k lambda r d theta divided by r square cos theta. Now here we have to vary theta, so let's r is r get cancelled. So we can write ex as k lambda by r into integration of sine theta d theta. Similarly for y we can write ey as k lambda over r integration d theta cos theta. Now we have to vary theta. See, we are measuring theta from y axis. And it is symmetrically placed in the xy plane here. So we can write this half angle would be alpha by 2 and this half angle would be alpha by 2. And theta is measured from this. It means this direction would be positive, or we can say clockwise direction would be positive. So if we want to vary theta, so here if we just take the opposite direction, we can write this angle as minus alpha by 2, and for right hand side for clockwise direction we can write this angle as plus alpha by 2. So we have to vary theta from minus alpha by 2 to plus alpha by 2, minus alpha by 2 to plus alpha by 2. Here we have lambda. So we can write ex as k lambda over r. What is sine theta? Sine theta is minus cos theta, and here we'll have minus alpha by 2 to alpha by 2. Similarly ey we can write k lambda over r and sine theta from minus alpha by 2 to alpha by 2. Now we can do one thing, let me rough this. Okay, so here if you'll see it is minus cos theta, so let's take minus outside. We can write ex as minus k lambda over r, and in bracket we'll put the values of theta. In this we'll get cos alpha by 2 minus cos minus alpha by 2, but cos is an even function, so cos minus theta would be cos theta. So we can write minus alpha by 2 as plus alpha by 2, and here we'll get cos alpha by 2 as 0. So ex, it means the net electric field in his x direction would be x 0. So we can directly say that there will be the net electric field only in y direction because of its symmetricity. So here while solving for y we can write k lambda over r, and just put the values sine alpha by 2 minus of sine minus alpha by 2. Sine is an odd function, so we can write sine minus theta as minus sine theta. These are mathematical description, you should know these small things. So we can write sine alpha by 2, and minus minus minus, this minus will come outside and minus minus will become plus. So we can write plus sine alpha by 2 for every odd function we can write. Now ey is 2k lambda divided by 2k lambda divided by r sine alpha by 2. It means we have the net electric field only in y direction, and this is very important result. You should remember this 2k lambda over r sine alpha by 2, where lambda is what? Lambda is the charge density which is given, r is the radius, k is constant 1 over 4 pi epsilon naught, and what is alpha? Alpha is the angle that this arc makes with center. Here see this angle, the angle that arc makes with the center. Now we'll proceed with some of the special cases. So let us consider semicircle. So for semicircle we can see here we have, let's consider lambda char distribution, the radius is r. Now with this drawing we can say it is making angle 180 degree or pi radian at the center. So we can write electric field, the net electric field would be in y direction, so we can write the net electric field would be 2k lambda over r into sin alpha. What is alpha here? Alpha is pi, sin pi by 2, and sin pi by 2 means sin 90, and we know that sin 90 is 1, so we can write net electric field as 2k lambda over r. You don't have to remember this formula, you just have to remember this case, the general case. Now if we have quarter circle, see here, this is our center having radius r and it has some charge distribution. So we can say that from this diagram, the net electric field would be in somewhere here, and we know the direct formula of that, and we can say that this arc is making angle 90 or pi by 2 at the center. So from the previous discussion, we can write the net electric field would be 2k lambda over r sin alpha by 2, alpha is pi by 2, so pi by 2 into 2 is pi by 4. So we can write it is as 2k lambda over root 2 r. Sin pi by 4 is 1 over root 2, so we can directly write it. Now the special case is, here we have a ring, it is not sphere, we have a ring which has some charge distribution, and it is uniformly spreaded over the circumference of ring, and the total charge is q. Now the radius is r, and at the center we have q naught. What is the tension in the ring? It means we have to find the tension in the ring due to repulsion between q naught and q. So first of all, we have to understand why this tension produced in the ring. See, if I just consider the half part of the ring, this is only half part, the dashed line are excluded, so we don't need it. Now we know that this half part is making semicircle, so its net electric field would be in this direction, and we can write force on q naught as q naught into electric field, and from that previous discussion we can write E as 2k lambda over r into, where lambda is the charge distribution, into what we can write sin alpha by 2. Sin alpha by 2 means here alpha is pi, sin pi by 2, which is sin 90, and it would be 1. So we can write fq naught as 2k lambda q naught over r, but here we don't have lambda, but we have, it is uniformly spreaded, so we can write lambda as q divided by l. Q divided by l, l means the length over which the charge is distributed. So in this ring we can write this whole length, it means its circumference would be, lambda can be written as q divided by 2 pi r, we can write it as. So force on q naught, force on q naught would be what, 2k q naught divided by r multiply by lambda, and it is q divided by 2 pi capital R. So this q and this q will get cancelled, and we'll have force on q naught will be k q into q naught divided by pi r square. This is the force, but we don't have to find the force on charge q naught. What is asked, we have to find the tension in the ring. So just pay attention, if this much of force is acting on charge q naught, so according to Newton's law we can also say this q naught is applying force on this semicircle also in the opposite direction. It means if this semicircle is pushing the charge away in this direction, so according to Newton's law we can say this charge is pushing this semicircle in the opposite direction. But here we have just assumed the semicircle, we have the whole ring. It means while getting pushed, this half ring will apply some tension in this direction on the other half of the ring. If this charge applying some force on this half ring, so this half ring would apply some tension at these two points, on which, on the other half ring. So this is T and this is T, but this ring is not breaking. It means this force is get balanced by these two tension. So we can write the force is get balanced by these two tension, and we can write tension as force divided by 2. And what is the value of force we have calculated? We have calculated k q naught divided by 2 pi r square. So this is the value of tension that the ring will apply at these two ends. So that is it for today, guys. I'll come up with other special cases also. There are a lot of cases that you should know, and you should remember the result of that famous cases. So until then, best of